The urn of late President Fidel V. Ramos is now at the Heritage Park in Taguig. The first 2 days of his wake are only open to family members. But starting on Thursday, his friends, colleagues, and supporters can pay their last respects to the former president based on a schedule. His family says this is to ensure that proper health and safety protocols will be observed during the wake. On Thursday, the wake is only open to government officials and members of the Ramos cabinet. On Friday, members of the diplomatic corps, the business community and civic organizations, as well as the media who covered FVR, will be free to visit his wake. Saturday is reserved for Ramos's colleagues from the West Point Academy, the Armed Forces of the Philippines, and other law enforcement agencies in the country. The wake will be open to the public on August 7th. From 7 a.m. to 2:30 p.m. and from 7 a.m. to 4 p.m. the next day. A mass and a prayer service will be held every 5 in the afternoon, while a tribute for the late president will take place every 6:30 p.m. Visiting hours will end every 10 p.m. On August 9, Ramos's remains will be brought to the Hero Cemetery, where he will be laid to rest along with his fellow presidents and war veterans. Ramos's family urged those who wish to send flowers for the late president to just donate to charity institutions close to FVR. Malacañang has yet to say if a state funeral will be held for the Philippines' 12th president. Historian Manolo Quezon explains state funerals are not automatically given to presidents who have passed away.
A president is entitled to a state funeral, is entitled to 10 days of national mourning. But the tradition is that all of this is offered by the sitting president and only announced when the family or if the family accepts. It's dependent on two things: the president has to offer and the family has to accept.
Former Health Secretary Jaime Galvez Tan says those close to Ramos knew that his health has been deteriorating since last year.
Last year, remember, it was his birthday, and I was telling all my friends who were with him, that let's see FBR, and they say even the family will not allow a visit. So I knew he was really in a difficult situation, and in a sense, the announcement was expected knowing his health conditions.
Aside from his work ethic, Galvez Dan says he looks up to Ramos's steadfast commitment to upholding peace in the Philippines. An irony, since the former president is one of the country's battle-tested and well-decorated soldiers.
I asked him, Mr. President, you are a general, but you know you have never acted at war. I mean, you made peace with the NPA, the Moro National Liberation Front, even with the Reform Armed Forces Movement. Why is it so that you, the general, are the peacemaker? And he was saying, Jimmy, if you knew what war was, because I was in the Korean War and the Vietnam War, you would never like to be again in a war.
It was during the Ramos presidency when the government forged a peace deal with the Moro National Liberation Front. Ramos also pushed for peace talks with communist rebels. Now, the general, who is also a peace builder, will soon be laid to rest. Katrina Domingo, ABS-CBN News.